Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today we're doing part two of the combo treatment, and we're doing the mid-face. So we're gonna use some Sculptra, platelet rich fibrin. Let's go to the video now. So the next step to this combination is treating the under eye. The under eye is the first area to age us. We're doing platelet rich fibrin. The least amount of filler we do, the better. We're using a Dermasculpt 25 gauge 1.5 inch microcannula, a little poke here. We create the opening. You do not need to go deep, just into the dermis. You stretch the skin side by side. That's what prevents the bruise. And then you try and find your opening, which can be a bit tricky. You give it a second, you can squeeze it. And I can see the opening right here. And what you want to do is slowly advance. We already treated the lateral orbital rim about a year ago, and you can see it's nice and filled. We don't need to add any filler there. I advance, I put some PRF in, but I want to get medial this time. So I'm going to traverse through, inject a little bit of product as I go, and that creates a potential space. You can see she produced a really nice amount from two tubes of platelet rich fibrin. PRF is different from PRP in that there's no heparin in this. So the idea is we're forming a clot underneath the skin, and you'll get slow release of growth factors. And that's what helps, what I believe, plump the fat a little bit, tighten the skin, create a little bit of volume, and just overall rejuvenate the area. And there we go, that's a nice amount. The eye will look a little baggy for maybe a day, maybe two, depends on how much you do. But actually, by tomorrow, it'll probably look really nice because it'll act like a little bit of filler where that clot is. So we're using Sculptra in the temples. That's the next step, getting a nice natural lift in the temple region. This is very specific and precise to do. But what I want to show is when you let the Sculptra vial sit, you can see that Sculptra gathers here. If you inject that, that's going to create a nodule, not necessarily in the temple because we should be on bone, but in the soft tissue. If we bunch those products up, that will create that. So what do? We put air in here and then back and forth, we agitate it. Again, don't let Sculptra sit more than 30 seconds without doing this so that it's agitated again. Get all of the air out of there. And this is key. This is key to Sculptra success. Treat your Sculptra great, it will treat you wonderful. Then you have got to make sure there's no air. You don't want to find that out when the needle's in the patient that it's not working. So we cleanse the area. We've pre-cleansed our patient, but I still cleanse afterwards. And a good way is 91% alcohol peroxide and then finally hypochlorous acid. Be careful if you're using HibiCleanse about anaphylaxis and corneal issues. Find the bone, but don't touch where we're injecting. And now you're going to get a poke here. We're coming in above the zygomatic bone through the temporalis, superficial and deep temporalis fascia. You can feel them both. You have got to be on periosteum. I feel it there, but you don't hit it hard. Pull back ever so slightly. Look at the hub so that you know there's no arterial flash. You sometimes will get a venous flash. You can put the entire 1.5 to 2.5 cc's here. You see it fill. I like to come posteriorly also. Pull back again and inject because that will lift the brow. Of course, it makes the high cheek look better, and it means we can add more in the high cheek because it will be congruent with the temple, but it also lifts the edge of the eye and a little bit of pressure there. They almost never bleed, almost never, but I still like pressure. Pressure prevents a bruise. So that's part two. Stay tuned in our future video. We're going to do part three and do the lower face. Add your comments below and let me know, what do you do for these treatments? Join us here on this channel. Subscribe also on Facebook and on Instagram for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.